Hey everyone, I'm out here in the garage. What we're gonna be doing today is replacing the struts on the 2004 Honda Pilot. So stay tuned. So if you're new to the channel, I just wanna welcome you here and hopefully you'll consider subscribing if you like what you see. Also, check out Car Apprentice on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I post lots of pictures and videos on those platforms before I post anything on YouTube. And occasionally, I'll post things on those platforms I don't post on YouTube. Also, check out the website at carapprentice.com. And don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video. So we're going to replace the struts on the Honda Pilot. And the reason for that is because I heard a clunking noise, which I thought was related to the struts, but actually turned out to be something else. So I did a little bit of diagnosis, but obviously not enough. And that's the conclusion that I came to, which was incorrect. So the struts were bad on this car, and we're gonna show that procedure in this video, but I still have to get to the bottom of why I'm hearing some clunky noise and a little bit of popping noise when I'm driving the car. So I worked on a relative's Infiniti G35X that had a bad axle, and I believe that's what happened on the Pilot also, but I didn't take a clue from that car. So one thing we're going to tackle in this video is compressing the springs on the Honda Pilot struts, which I've heard are not very easy to do, but I've actually found a method that works pretty well, and we'll detail that in this video. So, let's get into it. Here's the noise I was hearing while driving over bumps. Alright, so we're going to walk through the checks I performed, minus the axle test, of course, in an attempt to diagnose the issue. First, I checked the engine mounts since I just replaced the mount on the passenger side and I thought there was a possibility one of the other mounts was now showing up more prominently as having failed. I started the car, put my left foot on the brake and left the parking brake on, then I put the car in drive. I proceeded to tap the gas a couple times and observed whether the engine lurched and clunking noise could be heard. I repeated this test with the car in reverse. We'll move on to the suspension next, starting with the ball joint, which is near the bottom of the wheel. Ball joints can be very loud when they fail. My 1999 Acura RL had very bad ball joints at one point, and the car sounded like a junker when it drove. The noise is coming from the driver's side, but I'm going to demonstrate on the passenger side. With the car on jack stands, I'm just going to grab the wheel at 12 o'clock and 6 o'clock, then rock it in and out. Nothing. I've taken off the wheel and these stabilizer links are up next. I'll just grab the bar near each one of the joints and pull back and forth, then up and down. I also checked the boots for damage. Nothing. The stabilizer links are connected to the stabilizer bar that has bushings. Bad bushings can exhibit clunking noise. Visually they look just fine, but I'm going to use a pry bar to see if there's any movement. Nothing. My suspicion, which proved to be incorrect, was that the strut mount on the driver's side was bad. So I grabbed the spring near the top of the mount, then pulled down to see if there was any movement. There was a little bit of movement on the driver's side, but in the end, there wasn't enough to definitively proclaim the strut to be the issue. Another test you can try, which doesn't always work well with McPherson struts, is to have the car on the ground and push down on the fender and observe whether the struts rebound without bouncing. The last test we'll perform involves the tie rods that go to the steering rack. A visual inspection of the boots and grabbing the tie rod and moving it in and out and from side to side should reveal any issues. We got nothing here. Okay, so let's get into the strut replacement. The front end of the car is on jack stands with the wheel removed, so check out the video I made on jacking up the front end of the Pilot if you're unsure. Next, we'll remove the bolt attaching the speed sensor to the strut with a 10mm socket. The speed sensor should not be removed. Then we'll remove the bolt for the brake line with a 12mm socket. There are a couple ways to loosen the stabilizer link's nut. The first option is to use a 6mm hex key to hold the joint in place, then remove the nut with a 17mm box wrench. The second option is to use a 19mm open-end wrench or an adjustable wrench to hold the joint in place from the back, then remove the nut with a 17mm box wrench or a 17mm socket. Alright, so the large bolts are up next, which require 22mm tools. I used a socket on a breaker bar to loosen the nuts. The bolts most likely will not move while the nuts are loosened, but I've set a 22mm wrench on the bolt head just in case. It gets a little tricky from here since the knuckle is not attached anywhere above, as in the case of double wishbone suspension. To remove the bolts, it may not be a bad idea to install a lug nut on one of the studs, then use a ratchet strap to keep the knuckle stationary. I grabbed a bungee, which isn't the best thing to use, and tapped on the bolts with a brass hammer while pressing in on the knuckle. Now that the lower bolts are out, we'll turn our attention to the strut nuts at the top. These access covers can be removed with the screwdriver, then the nuts are removed with the 14mm socket. Also, I have a magnet nearby to fish out the nuts. I left the nut closest to the fender for last so I could reach underneath with my left hand to brace the strut and keep it from falling. Okay, so I've got the strut in the jaw horse, and I'm making some alignment marks to make sure the parts are oriented correctly on the new strut. What I assumed is that I could just make marks on any side of the strut since the new strut is identical. Wrong, as you'll see in a bit. It's best to make marks using the end of the spring as a point of reference, kind of like what I showed in the RL video. Okay, so here's a difficult part I've read about on the pilot forum, which is compressing the spring because of the size and contours of the upper and lower mounts respectively, and the pressure required. As you can tell by the marks on the upper plate, I tried a few methods using the conventional compressors available at the local AutoZone or O'Reilly's as loaners. The goal, as you may have seen in the RL strut videos, is to grab an optimal number of coils with the compressors, which is 4 in this case. If you grab less than 4, the spring will not be adequately compressed. I've forgotten that I have these Performance Tool W80555 compressors that have hooks. You can also find them as Lyle 62300 or Powerbilt 647089. They normally sell for between $30 and $70 a set. The problem is that they're not very tall and can only grab 3 of the pilot's coils. So I started the process by stripping off the lower plastic coil cover to make it easier for the hooks of each compressor to fit. I then grabbed 3 coils with the stork compressors close to 180 degrees apart, positioning them just off the upper plastic cover and with the hex on the bottom. Also, don't forget to set the safety pins.
Tightening to lift this hex.
just outside this cover. Not quite 180. Using 19 millimeter wrenches, I started compressing the spring. Once the upper plastic cover was clear of the upper mount, I removed it from the spring. Now that the spring was compressed enough so that the W80055 compressors could grab four coils, I started installing them at close to 180 degrees apart. To tighten the nuts for the hooks, a 14 millimeter wrench is needed. To tighten the compressors, a 26 millimeter wrench or a large adjustable wrench is required. So I just evenly compressed the spring until I felt it shift on the lower mount. Next, we'll start carefully removing the upper nut with a 6mm hex key and a 17mm box wrench. I just gradually loosen the nut and verify that a gap is forming between the large washer and the strut mount. You can tighten the compressors as needed, but don't get too carried away with this. And there it is.